welcome you all with my love and respects. Today, the Nirahara Samyama, second level, sixth day. So people are successful in fasting 8 days already. We have also completed the 11th Inner Awakening program successfully yesterday. Let's enter into today's satsang, Bhagavad Gita, 5th chapter, Sannyasa Yoga, 17th verse. Tatbuddhayas tatatmanas tannishtas tatparayana gacchanti apunaravrittim jnana nirtuta kalmashaha. Beautiful verse. I'll do the live translation. Tatbuddhayas tatatmanas tannishtas tatparayanaha gacchanti apunaravrittim jnana nirtuta kalmashaha. Tatbuddhyas, who are established in the intelligence. See, establishing yourself on intelligence. One of the biggest problem human beings face, they again and again tell you, I understand what is right and what is wrong, but I forget and do my own things. This is the one statement I hear from everybody every day. I understand what is right, what is wrong, but when it comes to action, I do my own things as per the old pattern. We need to understand, you are not born with the patterns with which you are working. When you are not born with them, you can change them. Please understand, when you are not born with certain pattern, it means it is created in you. Anything created can be changed. Now you can destroy the old one and create the new pattern. But constantly, for years and years and years, you go on cribbing, no, I know what is right, what is wrong, but I cannot do, I cannot look, I cannot see, I cannot change. Tat buddhyas means established in buddhi, means knowing clearly, anything I created, I can destroy and recreate the new one. I have seen two types of people. People who create that cribbing pattern. Oh, I know what is right or wrong, but when I act the way that my patterns are. There's other group who think, let me try little. This group which cribs is in the level of cribbing even for next 2 years. What 2 years? Even for 20 years, they will not be doing anything other than cribbing. But this group which tries, comes out of the old pattern, maybe in 2 or 3 months, because every time you think, I cannot, you are giving strength to your ignorance. Every time you think, I can, you are giving strength to your buddhi. Every time you think, it's okay, what is the need for transformation? with so much of struggle, you give strength to your tamas. Giving strength to your intelligence, tat buddhyas, establishing yourself in intelligence, means every step trying to change you 1 inch, trying to transform you just 1 inch extra, inch by inch trying to transform you. Tadbuddhyas tatatmanas tannishtas tatparayanaha, establishing yourself in intelligence. Tatatmanas, second word, establishing yourself in the truth that you are Atman, the soul, consciousness. I tell you, the moment you remember your consciousness, the moment you remember you are the Atman, you are the pure soul, millions and millions of patterns becomes useless for you. I tell you, if you want to cross any pattern, it should become useless to you. You will never be able to cross by fighting. No. I tell you, you can never quit smoking by fighting with that pattern. You can never quit drinking by fighting with that pattern. You may be drinking to escape from something. You may be smoking to prove yourself as something or somebody. Maybe smoking makes you feel good about you. Maybe drinking makes you forget something about you. Only when the utility disappears, addiction can disappear. Without alcohol, if you are able to divert yourself from your sufferings just by meditation or some other activity, then alcohol may be useless in your life. Only when it becomes useless, you will be able to come out of that pattern. Same way smoking. Without smoking, if you are able to give that same feeling towards yourself, that you are something which smoking gives, then smoking becomes useless to you. Only when things become useless to you, you can walk out of those patterns. When you remember you are the Atman, soul, there are millions of patterns in your life becomes useless. Just useless. You do not need them anymore. I should tell you from my experience. Once in Canada, one of my devotees, he forced me to come to a mall. And I have never seen a mall before that. I think in Toronto only. He wanted to show a mall for me. He said, "What is mall?" He said, "Everything. From clothes to computers, books, coffee, watches, everything will be available, Swamiji." I said, "What am I going to do?" He said, "No, no, no, please come, Swamiji. You may like something, something may be useful, we can pick up." I said, "Shopping? I never did that in my life." I said, "No. I have nothing to buy. Whatever I want, a few things which I use, thousands of people buy that for me from around the world and poor. The moment they see I use this hand key, do you know how many thousands of these hand keys I get every year? not hundreds, thousands. If I use every day 10, if I never touch again, if I don't touch the sand key second time, even then I will have enough supply for next 5 years. And the moment they see I use this mic, you don't know how many of these mics I get receive as gift. The moment they see that I use this cloth, tiger skin printed, you don't know how many meters I get. I told him, I don't need to shop. Whatever few things, I use very less things, but whatever things I use, people pour on me. But he was a devotee. He was not ready to listen. He said, no, 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 Swamiji, please come, please come. I just wanted to take you and show you, get something for you. I said, all right. We went. Almost 2.5 hours he showed me. 2.5 hours I spent in that mall. It's one of the largest mall, I think. It's just next to Swaminarayan Temple in Toronto. There's a huge Swaminarayan Temple. And after 2.5 hours, when I came out, I was just filled in ecstasy. It's such a personal experience, what I can share with you. So actually, when I entered, I told myself, hey, whatever you want, you pick up, no problem. I entered in a very casual, playful mood. And I told the devotee also, don't worry, whatever I want, I'll surely pick up. After 2.5 hours, going through the whole thing, when I came out, I tell you, not even one object seems to be useful in my life. It's an honest experience I'm sharing with you. Went round and came out. See, I'm not trying to tell you this to teach renunciation for you. I am not saying you should also be like this. No. I am not using this situation to teach you some serious concept. I am telling you exactly the lightness of the whole situation. Please understand. I entered very light way, very playfully, very relaxed way. He's a close disciple who is begging me to pick up something. Literally asking as a boon, please pick up something. I'll be happy to give you that. Going around and coming back with that same light mood. Please understand, if I am in the bhava of Kalabhairava or giving Kalabhairava darshan or Kalabhairava swarupa, then I don't need anything. That is perfect. Kalabhairava does not need anything. But even in an ordinary, playful, down-to-earth mood, when the mind does not want anything, understand, whole world becomes useless to you. The moment you remember you are pure consciousness, even playfully, even in an ordinary way, whole world becomes useless to you. Please understand, millions of things will become useless to you. Only when things become useless to you, you will be able to walk out of the patterns created by those things. When I came out, I told the devotee, do you know how happy I feel to live with this body and mind? The body which does not ask anything, anytime, and never gives any pain, even if you fall from the horse. And the mind, even casually, playfully, does not feel any requirement of anything. Just feels. the whole thing is useless. I tell you, when you establish yourself in Atman, the concept, the idea, your consciousness, I tell you, you don't even need to make this as an experience. Even remembering that your consciousness can make millions of things useless in your life. Making millions of things useless in your life makes you more and more blissful. More and more things becomes useless in your life, more and more you become blissful. More and more you become joyful. More and more people become useless in your life, more and more you become free. When more and more life itself becomes useless in your life, more and more you are getting enlightened. I tell you, more and more things, people, life becomes useless to you, more and more you are getting liberated. Tadatmanas means contemplating the concept, your consciousness. Next, Tannishtas means established in the Supreme. Please understand, established in the understanding, your consciousness. Tatparayanaha, who has surrendered themselves to this great truth. When you are in Tadbuddhi, Tadatmana, Tannishta and Tatparayana, you are liberated from the all clutches. Jnana Nirdhuta Kalmashaha, you are liberated from all patterns and free from illusions. You are liberated from all patterns and free from illusions. Tadbuddhyas tatatmanas tannishtas tatparayanah gacchanti apunaravrittim jnana nirduta kalmashah. Beautiful word, apunaravrittim. You don't come back, you don't come down. When Bhagavan says you don't come down, it does not mean only about the next birth. Even the next day morning waking up, you will not be the same person. Establish yourself continuously into the ultimate, you will be a new being.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyanapitam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.